watching. Today you're going to do some hip mobility. I think most of the people asked for that in the end. Although when I checked and I announced that I'm going to do hips and shoulders, they were both of the same people, but some people voted afterwards. So I will do some shoulders anyway as well. But today we start with the hips. Due to all these things going on with the corona and the COVID-19, I do not have a guinea pig or a show model. So I'll be showing stuff myself. I would like, before we start with some mobility, I would like to explain a little bit more about mobility.
Alright, so before we actually start with the hip mobility drills, I would like to explain you something about mobility and flexibility and the muscles that we are going to stretch. If you're not interested in this, which I can understand, I will put the time in the screen of when the drills are actually starting. So let's first start with the difference between flexibility and mobility. You can see here in a row two pictures. The first picture is showing you mobility, and the second picture is showing you flexibility. So flexibility is a passive thing. It's a person's ability to move their connective tissue with the help of another person or tool, so my hand in this picture, while their muscles passively allow them to the movement to happen. Mobility is our ability to take our body through a range of motion before being constricted with control. So if you see the second picture with my hand being a lot less far, that is when we're talking about mobility. So if you, for another example would be bringing up your leg as high as you can bring it up without using your hands, but if you use your hands or an elastic band, you can probably bring it up a little bit farther. So when we are actually stretching, which is a passive stretch which you're holding, you're lengthening your muscles. This is not something that will always stay there unless you're doing it for the whole day, every day. Mobility is something that you can work on because you can control it, and it will also help you with a bigger range of motion. But for mobility, you need sometimes to flex and to work on your flexibility of your muscles, which means that when you're doing a mobility drill, it's the best to first work a little bit on lengthening those muscles so they allow you to get a bigger range of motion, and then work on your mobility. To work on your mobility, you always activate a muscle that is normally not so active, and you try to stretch a muscle that is a little bit too active. So that to show you that, I will also explain a little bit about the muscles that we're going to stretch and to use. So here you see a picture of the bigger muscles in the butt. Now that we're sitting every day, you're stretching actually your hamstrings, which are compromised of different muscles, as well as your gluten, which, and your hip flexors, which are on the other side, which are bringing your legs up or helping you when you're squatting, are always in a compromised form, so they're shortened. Because we're sitting the whole day and the gluten are being stretched the whole day, another small muscle, the piriformis, or the pear-shaped muscle, is sometimes taking over the function of our butts, which is to extend the leg to the back or help you come up when you're standing up. This can be one of the muscles that is causing us a little bit of pain in the hips. Next to that, we also have the psoas iliacus. It is actually two muscles. You can see them here as well. They're very deep muscles, and those are attached on the front side. They're actually the hip flexors, and on the lower back. Your psoas ilias is connected to your quadratus lumborum, that is on the back side of your lower back. And your quadratus lumborum does the exercise that you see in this picture. So if you move with your left hand towards your left knee, it will help you move around. Due to the psoas being tight, it's pulling on that muscle, and it makes you sometimes feel like you want to stretch your back, although it's not that muscle that is painful. It is probably the psoas ilias. So we're going to work a little bit on stretching these muscles. I just also want to say that this was a very, very short explanation of found very, very basic anatomy. There is a lot more going around on the hips. So if you have any pain or experiencing any pain, I would highly advise you to visit also a physiotherapist, because this movie is not going to solve this pain. There's also other things that can happen. But this is some of the things that we see mostly when we're sitting a lot. which is also why we're doing the stretches today. I hope you will enjoy it, and let's get into the stretches and some of the dynamic stretches. I will be showing you first some stretches to lengthen your muscles. All of these stretches you're holding at least 30 seconds, and this is how long it takes for a muscle to actually relax in this length. After that, I will be showing you the dynamic stretches. Some of those stretches might seem like you're actually working on some of the other muscles, which should be the case. For the normal stretches, you don't need any materials, but for the dynamic stretches, you're going to need two chairs with a backrest and a broomstick that is rather long, or a PVC pipe if you took a PVC pipe from the box.
So come lay down on your back with one leg in length, and you're gonna move the other leg over your leg on the floor. So from this side it looks like this. So your feet is on the floor, you're laying on the floor, and your arms are stretched out completely next to your shoulders. I'm going to show it on this side because it's easier for you to see. So my feet is on the floor, and the opposite arm is going to go on my knee, and I'm going to pull my knee towards the floor without taking my shoulders off the floor. So this arm is staying there. I'm going to pull it down as far as I can. You'll feel a stretch here and in your butt, for some people probably also in their lower backs. You're going to switch, so from this side it looks like this. Arm is straight, and I'm going to bring down this knee as far as I can towards the floor. I'll show you from the front. Stretch we're doing is a pigeon stretch. It's a stretch you've probably all already seen before. We're going to start like this in a lunge. You're going to put your leg on the floor with your upper leg 90 degrees angle with your hips, and your lower leg is a 90 degree angle with your knee. And your weight is going to stay in the middle, so you're not going to fold down and sit here. Your weight is in the middle, and you're going to try and work your hips to the floor. So some people means they're sitting up here, that's fine. Try and walk your hands up here and sit straight. Are you able to get to the floor without dropping to the side? You can come down and hold it here. If you're sitting like this, bring the weight back up here and hold your pose here. Pull your belly button in and push the back leg away. It's a stretch for here. So if we're falling here, we're not stretching the muscles that are supposed to be stretched with this muscle, because you need to keep them straight. So hold them here and hold this for 30 seconds as well. From the front side, it looks like this. The lunge. This leg is coming down. 90 degree. Push your back leg back as far as you can. Don't fall down, but sit here and try and work your hips towards the floor if you can. Come down. Walk your hands forward. Keep on working your weight to the middle if you feel that you're moving towards this side. So it's a constant fighting against letting go of the stress that you're feeling and holding it. The next stretch we're doing is a sitting stretch for the inner part of your neck, for your adductorum. If you are not able to sit with a straight back like this, or when your knees are really high, grab yourself a towel or a blanket and sit on top of that until you can straighten your back. Otherwise, you can keep your foot here, press them together, and come forward with a straight back, and hold it here. You should feel the stretch inside, on the inside of your legs. Sit here and hold this for 30 seconds. After this one, we're going to do a couch stretch. For this, as the word says, you need a couch, a wall, or a chair. I'm going to show it with a chair because my wall is not very comfortable for my feet. You're going to sit in front of your chair. You're going to put your feet on top of the chair, and your knee is going to be on the floor. Bring your front foot up, so now that you're in a lunge, and then bring your body up as far as you can. You should feel it here in your upper leg. Keep your back straight, so not going to bend like this. Keep your back straight. Hold it here for 30 seconds. Try and work your butt back to your heel. So if you're staying here because you can't go any further, that's fine. But try and work up your body towards your heel. So you start from here. And if it's possible, you come up a little bit higher. See how far you can go. Push, 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 push. And hold it there. Hold it in a tight spot. Alright, after this one, we're going to get a cobra stretch or an upward facing dog, depending who you ask, or some really complicated name in Sanskrit. We do a lot of, before I do this stretch, I just want to talk about this stretch because we do it quite often as well in the books. And what I see a lot of people do is hanging like this. This is not the point of the stretch. You have to pull your shoulders back. You're stretching out the whole front side of your body, including your hip flexors. And if you're like this, your back is probably trying to work it way forward, but your shoulders are here and here, so you cannot bend your back well. If you pull your shoulders to the back, you can bring your chest forward, you can bring your belly forward, and you can stretch the muscles on the front side that are normally doing this. So, to get in the stretch in the right way, come lay down on the floor. Your hands are going to be under your shoulders as if you're doing a push-up, and your toes are going to be relaxed on the floor. We're not going to bring up our legs and our hips, that's a later stage. We're only bringing up our shoulders and our back. First, pull your shoulders back. Pull yourself up as far as you can and hold it here while you look up. If this is very easy, and if you're doing yoga, or if you have no problems keeping your shoulders back and you're not hanging like this, but your shoulders are pulled to the back, you curl your toes on the floor and you bring your legs off the floor. Stay with your shoulders to the back. As you can see, this costs me a lot of effort, which is why a lot of people tend to do it wrong. What you see happening in the books is this. This is not the stretch. Shoulders to the back, push out, and lean your hips towards the floor. If that's too heavy, you put your legs and your hips on the floor. Look up. Stay there. So from the front, it looks like this. Shoulders are pulled to the back. Shoulders are pulled to the back. Push yourself up. Look up. You're not leaning here. Shoulders are back. Chest is forward. If this is easy, bring up your toes to the floor and lean here. This is a cobra stretch. The last stretch we're doing is a sitting, or is a kneeling, ab or front side stretch. Come and sit down on your knees, up straight. You want to keep from your knees until your shoulders, this is going to be straight. You're going to come down until you touch with your fingertips your heels. You should feel a stretch here. If this is easier, not feeling a stretch, come down a little bit lower. Keep your body straight, so don't go push out your chest. Everything is straight. Don't bring down like this. Your butt should be tight. This should be straight and stretching. See how far you can come while keeping your body straight. But watch out for your knees. Feel the stretch and eventually bring your head also to the back and stay here. So we're going on to the dynamic movements, to dynamic stretches. And dynamic stretch in general activates one muscle while stretching the other one. So at the moment we're stretching our hips, which and if you're going to do hip flexors on the front side, it means that we're squeezing the back side. So the first one we're doing is a bridge. So come lay down on the floor. Put your feet flat on the floor, on hip width. You should just be relaxed on the floor like this. Cross your arms over your chest, and you're going to bring up your butt towards the ceiling by squeezing your buttock and come up. As you can see, this is now straight, which means we're flexing our front side, but we're also squeezing our butt because most of the time that is the one that is not working hard enough. And then we come down and we come up again. You do this 10 times. Squeak up and slow descent. Quick up and slow descent. After the bridge, we're doing the kneeled hip flexor. Come sit down again in a big lunge step. Your back feet are your toes are in the floor, or they're pointing a little bit outward, not all the way this, a little bit. You're up straight, your back is straight. Now you're going to bring up the arm of the leg that is down, so I'm going to bring up this arm. And you try and press your pelvic towards the ceiling. So you're not bending your back like this, you're doing only move your pelvic. You should feel a stretch here. You bring up your arm and you're going to turn. So from the front, it looks like this, I'm straight. My leg, back leg is turned out a little bit. I bring my pelvic towards the ceiling. I lift my hand up and I turn and come back. To do this, you have to squeeze your butt again. Otherwise, you cannot turn. It would look like this. So you can see that my hips are a lot looser. I have to squeeze my butt and turn. Alright, now we're going to do a other stretch, but you need two chairs and a broomstick. The broomstick should ideally be on the upside of your hips, but as you can see, my head is a little bit lower because I do not have chairs or anything that is high enough for me, which means I have to squat down a little bit lower. I know I'm able to do that, but maybe you can get somebody to hold it up for you or find another, or your chairs are higher. So what you're going to do is you're going to make a nice and big step with your foot under the broomstick, and you're going to come and squat down, which means you're going to have a nice stretch on the middle of your legs. You're going to come all the way under, turn the back foot in, pull it down, so you have a nice stretch on the front, and work in the opposite direction, bend it there. So on the way back, you're doing the same thing, come up, nice stretch in the middle, to the other side, put your leg down, so we're going to have a nice stretch here, and bring your body to the opposite direction of the leg that is on the floor. You do both sides 10 times. Alright, the next one is a walking four, as I call them. What you're going to do is you're going to walk straight, or if you don't have enough space, you're going to stand on one spot. You're going to bring your leg up, pull it in, so this is straight, pull your leg in, step forward, other one up, in, step forward. As last one, we have the IT bend from Jane Fonda. This is a very Jane Fonda movement. It is mainly to focus for the people that have tight hips here on the side. So this is bothering you often, or your legs on the side are bothering you, or you feel sometimes something is pulling on your knee on this side. It is working mostly on the muscle that is not doing enough of its work. So what you're going to do is to come and lay down on your side. Make sure that your hips are stacked on top of each other. So these bones are exactly on top of each other. So don't roll forward or lean back. They're on top of each other, which can be very uncomfortable. And then your bottom leg is going to be straightened up, and your top leg is going to come slightly to the back. And you're going to bring it up on the back, up as far as you can. While you squeeze here. So you're squeezing your buttock and you come down. And squeeze up. Try and keep your hips above each other, so don't roll to the back. They're staying on top of each other. Squeeze up and down. It should cost you a lot of effort. If this is not the case, try and look if you're really on top of each other. Get your housemate, roommate, partner to see if you're laying straight or if you're not rolled out. And on both sides, you're going to do 10 of these reps. All right, these were the exercises for today. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you enjoyed the information that I give you. And for now, I'll see you next time. And let us know if you have any questions. Hopefully you had a great day.